Yeah. Good to see you.
Sam Brownback is seen as a happy-go-lucky guy.
Wow, good to see you guys.
But times aren't so happy right now for the Kansas governor. He faces a tight race in what is usually considered a safe place for Republicans.
It's been tough.
The problem centers on the economy. His critics say it's in shambles, but Brownback says not so fast.
We are strong in this state, and that but transitions are hard.
That transition began in 2010 when the former senator brought his Tea Party style of conservatism to Kansas. In 2012, the governor helped pass the biggest tax cut in America during the last 20 years. He said it would lead to economic growth, but so far, the results aren't there.
He was very forthright about this, almost too forthright. He said this was an experiment.
We'll see how it works. We'll have a real live experiment.
While Brownback implemented spending cuts, there weren't enough to make up for the loss in tax revenue.
If you're going to cut revenue, then you also need to adjust spending. It wasn't done.
The state's bond rating has been downgraded, and critics say by 2016, the projected budget deficit will reach almost $240 million. Brownback backers say only part of the story is being told. They point out that when he took office, the state already faced a shortfall of $550 million. Now, 4 years later, 55,000 jobs have been created, and the unemployment rate stands at 4.9%. That's below the national average.
Tax policy takes some time for it to work. We'd always projected declining revenues for 2 years. Always have projected that.
Paying for education has also been an issue here. Democrat Paul Davis is hitting his opponent for cutting classroom spending. Brownback denies that, saying overall education spending is actually up.
They lied about it.
One thing is for sure, the governor's changes led to a number of moderate Republicans jumping ship. Wint Winter set up Republicans for Kansas Values to back Brownback's opponent because they've seen enough of a downward spiral.
We don't want to wait any longer. To wait longer would be irresponsible. It would be sort of the equivalent of Wizard of Oz clicking our heels three times and hoping, you know, magically this all works, but it hasn't and it won't.
How disappointed were you in these moderate Republicans we hear so much about that kind of jump ship and have decided to support your opponent here? What was that like for you?
Well, for a number of them, this isn't their first rodeo. They supported Kathleen Sebelius for governor first time around. And many of them, not all of them, but many of them support tax increases in Obamacare.
This shapes up as a battle over the role of government. Trabert says big government politicians are threatened.
It's about, we don't want this form of government, this citizen-focused, better service, better price government, to kick in because it changes the culture of how government operates.
The race really does shine a light on the intense fight for control between conservatives and moderates within the Republican Party. A new Gallup poll shows 38% of Kansans are conservative, but an almost equal amount, 36%, say they're moderate. Out of the top 10 Republican voting states, Kansas ranked the least conservative of all of them.
Will Kansas go back to a somewhat more moderate conservative stance where it's been over the last 40 or 50 years?
Brownback further alienated moderates in 2012 when he supported conservative Republican challengers over moderate incumbents in order to tilt the legislature in his favor.
He decided that some of the people with the same colored jerseys on, he wanted off the team.
Brownback is pushing back.
Then why do I have moderates in the cabinet?
And like sharks smelling blood in the water, enemies are hitting from all sides.
But I think the left is just so desperate to see, they want this model to fail so bad.
This whole political ordeal has tested the governor's faith, no doubt about it.
I like to tell people I've been growing, which is what's taking place.
But Brownback is moving full steam ahead. Because the way Brownback sees it, he didn't become governor just to take up space.
When you hire a new coach or CEO of a company, you don't tell them, look, we're kind of in decline. Just manage the decline well. Don't make it hurt too much, okay? You hire them to say, you know, look, change this place. Get it going the right way. Build it. Let's grow.
Governor?
That's a message he hopes will keep him around as governor until the cows come home. David Brody, CBN News, near Topeka, Kansas.